It is the agenda for the 21st century you're living in today. For a brave new world where everything that you cherished and held true will no longer exist.
The death toll in the country reached 877 on Friday. A cholera outbreak is claiming more lives and tens of thousands are now homeless. Information has come in from remote areas that were cut off by the storm. At least 175 people are dead in villages clustered in the hills and on the coast of Haiti's fertile western tip. Rural clinics are overflowing with patients and many of them are receiving treatment late. Food has been scarce. At least 7 people have died of cholera, likely because of floodwaters mixing with sewage.
Destruction is everywhere in Jeremy, in southern Haiti. We visited the area on Friday, where 3 days after the hurricane, the city was still trying to cope with disaster. Thousands of houses have been destroyed, and there is not enough food and drinking water. At the local hospital, doctors say they're desperate for help.
Is this your first time to Lake Mead?
For me, not.
About once a decade, Hartmut Post heads to the airport in Hamburg, Germany, and flies across 2 continents to holiday here at Lake Mead. This time, it's still beautiful, he says, but somehow it's just not the same.
The level of the water was much higher 10 years ago when I was here.
It's lost almost all of its leaves already.
Canadian researcher Glenn McDonald spent more than 2 decades studying drought in California. He says in the state's prehistoric past, rising temperatures locked California into drought that lasted hundreds, even thousands of years. According to his newly published study, high levels of greenhouse gases may cause California's climate history to repeat itself.
Drought becomes, in a sense, the new climatology. It becomes the new normal.
This long-term drought is already affecting the crops California farmers are choosing to grow and export to Canadian tables.
Reptiles. sun is right there. I don't know if it's going to film right.
These creepy clowns and threats online will continue to grow.
A woman claims she was attacked by a man in a clown suit just this morning.
It seems as if a new report of a threatening clown pops up by the hour.
Police have their hands full with these possible sightings.
A clown reportedly appeared inside these woods.
What the fuck is that? You're right there, mate. Fuck!
He's running. Get in the car.
Hang up the phone. Call 911.
Oh my God.
Stop recording.
Call.
That is so creepy. What the fuck is that? Oh God.
Oh my God.
Oh, no! Hurry the fuck up!
Oh shit! What? Oh, what the fuck?
No, go, 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 go!
There's no contact.
I swear to God.
Dude, what the hell,
what
man?
What the fuck is that, dude?
Holy shit.
Yo, what's your problem? What's your fucking problem?
Going back to late August, there have been dozens of reports of threatening clowns, largely centered around schools and colleges. Many have been dismissed by law enforcement as pranks, but more than a dozen people have been arrested in connection with the sightings.
Around 12:30 Friday afternoon, police say two men jumped out of their car and opened fire with assault rifles on a 24-year-old man.
Only thing I can say is he was shot multiple times and he is in critical condition right now.
An Ethiopian government website is reporting that 11 companies, ranging from textile firms to a commercial flower farm, were attacked by the protesters, and more than 60 vehicles were torched. The violence occurred just outside the capital, Addis Ababa. It comes just days after 55 people were killed in a stampede southeast of the capital that began after police fired tear gas at demonstrators. It's the latest in a wave of unrest that political opponents say has claimed 450 lives since 2015. The unrest centers on the government's drive to industrialize the country.
The Congress of South African Trade Unions has almost 2 million members, and many of them are parents. It supports the student protests for free education and says big business should help pay for it.
We fully support their demands. We fully support the initiative that government has taken, but we think there's a broad space where we can engage and be able to realize the issue of free education.
This unique exhibit, called Forced from Home, offers visitors the chance to see the world from the eyes of the 65 million people who are currently displaced.
In Turkey's capital, where another round of deadly explosions took place on Saturday, two suicide bombers detonated the car bombs in Ankara after police called on them to surrender. Suspects believed to be a man and a woman were dead on site.
German police have arrested three suspects in connection with a hunt for a Syrian-born man suspected of planning a bomb attack. Police also say that they have found several hundred grams of explosives in an apartment that they raided in the eastern city of Chemnitz.
From Frankfurt to London to Washington, central banks are under siege.
And we have a Fed that's doing political things. This Janet Yellen of the Fed. The Fed is doing political by keeping the interest rates at this level.
Other Republicans have claimed the Fed chief is cozy with the Obama administration, keeping interest rates low to help the U.S. president's popularity. She denies it.
The Federal Reserve is not politically compromised. We do not discuss politics in our meetings.
Central banks like the Federal Reserve are used to being criticized by investors. After all, raising and lowering interest rates always makes someone unhappy.
Well, President Obama just called everyone at the CIA, the FBI, the NSA, and the Department of Defense racist, proving that he has simply lost his mind. Elizabeth Harrington for the Washington Free Beacon reports that President Obama, get this, is ordering all national security agencies to expand the use of unconscious bias training, and address intersectionality in a late push for diversity and inclusion in the federal government. They write that the president issued a memorandum on Wednesday entitled Promoting Diversity and Inclusion in the National Security Workforce. The memo requires all 17 agencies, including the Pentagon, State Department, and Department of Homeland Security, to report back in 4 months on their progress in collecting information about diversity in their workforce, such as employees' sexual orientation and gender identity.
At the spot where an unarmed African American was shot and killed by a California police officer, people pour out their frustrations.
I've seen some of the racist attitudes that these police have, and there's no consequence. They brutally murder us out here in this country.
It needs to stop.
After a series of shootings involving police, the rise of the Black Lives Matter movement, and the gunning down of five police officers in Dallas, the racial chasm is deepening.
Racism continues to survive in this country and continues to have a central place.
Hillary Clinton just got the endorsement that will end her. We got it on the record right here. Will Quigg, who is a grand dragon for the Loyal White Knights and West Coast King Kleagle of the Ku Klux Klan from Anaheim, California, he went on the record not only endorsing Hillary Clinton but confirming that the KKK actually donated $25,000 to her. If elected president, Hillary Clinton will resettle 1 million Muslim migrants in her first term as president. That is according to the Department of Homeland Security. Now, I want to also note that the United Nations has also implemented a new strategy. It's called the New York Document. And with the new UN head of the Security Council there, guess what? They have a whole plan to force rich nations now, to shoulder the greatest burden of the refugee crisis. Now, the article continues that she will increase the inflow of refugees. So go to the link at Liberty Writers. You'll see it down below. You can see it for yourself. Now, also, in the new WikiLeaks drops from her staff, Chief of Staff John Podesta, there are emails from her campaign discussing how badly the Muslim migrants have been for Germany and the rest of Europe. This says it all, okay? These are Hillary Clinton's own words. It says, quote, Muslim immigration and multicultural madness have left a trail of misery and mayhem across Germany.
4 dozen Afghan troops training in the U.S. have vanished in less than 2 years. So why are they going AWOL, and is this a threat to our security? Pete Hegseth is a Fox News contributor and an Iraq and Afghanistan war veteran, and he joins us now with his reaction to this. You know, we're bringing this to people's attention this morning because it really is shocking when you say that, but this is something that you're familiar with.
Very much indeed. It's shocking, but it's something that's been going on for quite some time. I was a trainer in Afghanistan in 2011-2012. This was a concern of ours when we sent Afghans either to Europe or the United States. Because you got to remember, in the mindset of some of these Afghans, they're stuck inside an intractable war where the Taliban is gaining ground and gaining momentum. And the Americans are going to send them to Europe or the United States to train. And a lot of them see it as their opportunity to get out.
Well, it looks like Iraq is now warning of a regional war that could actually break out if Turkey does not withdraw its troops from the nation there. Zero Hedge reports that with much of the public's attention in recent weeks focused on the escalation between the United States and Russia over the nearly six-year-old proxy war in Syria, a reminder that Middle East tensions include virtually all other neighboring countries came from Iraq's prime minister, who on Wednesday warned Turkey that it risked triggering a regional war by keeping troops in its territory as neighboring states summoned each other's ambassador in a mounting diplomatic standoff.
The World Health Organization says at least 377 people have been killed and over 1,200 injured in eastern Aleppo over the past 2 weeks.
Running undercover, Libyan forces loyal to the UN-backed government are going street to street in Sirte. They're on a mission to recapture the city from Islamic State. IS controls a residential strip about a half mile long in the city's Neighborhood 3 district. But thanks to tank fire and intensified U.S. airstrikes, these fighters are hoping they can finish the fight soon. From here, they say IS is clinging to one last sub-district in the city, If seated, IS would be defeated in their main base outside Iraq and Syria.
An airstrike hit a packed funeral home in Yemen, killing more than 100 people, reportedly including top Shia rebel leaders.
Egypt and the United States used to hold military exercises together, but they were suspended back in 2008 for political reasons. Egypt has been waging a war against militant groups along its eastern and western borders. So Cairo decided to work more closely with Russia for assistance. This week's joint drills will focus on locating and destroying hostile armed groups in the desert. Egypt has been hosting other international players for drills as well. That includes Saudi Arabia.
The joint military exercises are the highest form of cooperation between countries. It is also clear that both Egypt and Russia have a common vision.
Russia just added hundreds of new warheads to its nuclear arsenal. According to Bill Gertz at the Washington Free Beacon, he reports that Russia increased its deployed nuclear warheads over the past 6 months under a strategic arms reduction treaty. They've added warheads under a reduction treaty. This is the U.S. nuclear warhead stock. Meanwhile, U.S. nuclear warhead stocks declined sharply, according to the State Department. They say that during the very same period, the United States cut its deployed nuclear warheads by 114, increasing the disparity between the two nuclear powers. Well, Vladimir Putin wants war, apparently. NATO jets from four countries intercepted Russian nuclear planes right outside of Europe. According to Fraser Moore for The Express, he reports that fears of a major confrontation between Vladimir Putin and the West were heightened after it was revealed that NATO jets from four countries were scrambled to intercept Russian bombers scouting off of Europe's coast.